To say this semester has been unusual would be quite the understatement. The coronavirus has affected each and every one of us in both similar and different ways. And as the university has adapted and confronted these challenges to protect their students, faculty, and staff, several parents and students are reaching out with their frustrations in regards to what the university is, or rather isn't, doing.
On a normal weekday morning, the parking lots would be packed, there'd be steady streams of students passing between the Union and Grove, and many classrooms would be full. But normalcy left in March, leaving many questions and challenges in its wake. But UM official Jem Zook says that the university administration has met these challenges with months of planning and preparation in order to transition back into the new academic year and the new normal.
There was extensive planning that went into this fall, and I think everybody knew going in that, yeah, this was going to be a challenging semester. We've never had a semester like this. We've never been in a pandemic before. We've never had to really rethink everything that we do as a university, not just how classes are delivered, but living arrangements, food service, etc.
That planning consisted of making decisions that would adhere to CDC guidelines and government mandates, and ultimately keep members of the Ole Miss family safe. A major call for the university was the decision to have some in-person, some hybrid, but mostly remote or online classes. And while some students are doing well with these formats, others, like sophomore Lydia Jauncey, are having more difficult experiences.
I had really also been struggling a little bit with some of my professors, just relating to them, reaching out to them. Their accessibility has just been so difficult, I feel like, this semester, which is to be expected. But I have had one professor in particular who has made it extremely difficult to succeed in her class without having prior knowledge of the materials.
Jauncey claims that in this particular class, there's virtually no instruction. And according to other Ole Miss students and parents, Jauncey's situation isn't all that unique. Pat Tucker, parent of an Ole Miss senior, has recently become a vocal member on the Keep Mississippi University's Open Facebook group. The group, composed of over 6,000 members, seems to be primarily dedicated to keeping Mississippi universities accountable for holding in-person classes as much as possible and delivering well-taught remote classes when it's not. Tucker shares that he, along with several other parents, doesn't feel the university is ensuring that their professors provide students with sufficient instruction.
I think we're shocked. We're dismayed. We feel like we have, we feel like there's a breach of contract here. We paid the university a lot of money for their professors to teach our students, and we're not getting that.
Tucker also shares that while students are facing a number of problems academically, the issues don't stop there. He states that multiple parents have reached out to him directly, or they've posted on the Facebook group about their students' mental and emotional problems through all of this. And Tucker believes that UM administration is showing a lack of empathy for these students.
The number of stories that we've seen from students and parents where students have had mental and emotional breakdowns and had their parents had to come get them, it's ridiculous. And the administration has shown no concern about those.
Stephanie Opolka, a mother of an Ole Miss freshman, is all too familiar with the emotional toll that this semester has had on students. A few weeks ago, she flew in from Maryland to take her son home after he experienced an emotional breakdown. Opolka shares that this semester has left her questioning her decision to send her son back to Ole Miss.
It almost, you start questioning, am I doing a disservice at the least, and at the worst, actual harm to my child by sending him back to a place who has demonstrated this poor decision making and a lack of empathy for these kids and figuring it out.
According to Zook, administration is aware of these issues that many students are facing and is committed to helping those that need it.
We're certainly aware that this environment is working better for some students and less well for others. If we know about specific needs for any individual student, we are taking action to help them get tutoring, if they need some form of counseling, if they need other forms of support, We are here to help, because that's why we're here, is to serve our students.
But according to parents like Tucker and Opolka, along with several others, these efforts aren't enough. Tucker says that parents, students, and alum have sent thousands of letters and emails to administration with little response. They've also reached out to government officials at the city, state, and national levels, hoping to incite some change. But according to Opolka, there's a simple solution for all of this.
And honestly, mine's simple. Open up the campus and teach our kids. Teach these students what they said they were going to teach and what we've paid them to teach, period. It's that simple for me.
For Tucker, the solution is a bit more complex. He states that the university should open up as much as possible, but he's also calling for academic relief for students, for the university to admit their mistakes, and to get to the root of the problem. But despite these feelings, Tucker shares that his intention through all of this isn't to hurt Ole Miss, but rather to save it.
I love Ole Miss. And really my ultimate goal besides saving these kids is saving the university. We're not out to get the university. We're trying to save it from apparently, you know, a situation certainly that's ruining the students, the reputation, you know, and the future of Ole Miss. And if you know, I'm fighting as much for Ole Miss as I am for these students.
After I had already spoken to the parents, Chancellor Boyce released a letter to Ole Miss parents on Tuesday outlining the university's plans to further support students for the remainder of the semester and in the upcoming spring semester. A few things Chancellor Boyce shares are the university's commitment to offering more face-to-face instruction, looking to expand classes to non-traditional spaces on campus and potentially off-campus locations, allowing for more options for student organizations to host activities off campus, extending the library's hours, and more. For a full list of these initiatives, you can visit coronavirus.olemiss.edu and read the Fall 2020 update. Kaylee Crafton, NewsWatch, Ole Miss.